What's up, guys? I know it's been a while that it'd be a long while that I've posted anything on this channel, but I've been like kind of busy. I've been in school and many other things like that, so I decided to like post something today. Now today I'll do something very simple. I want to talk about teenage life, or should I say life of a youth. But before we go to that, how about you click on that subscribe button, like and comment on what you think about this video so far and after the video. Now let's get back to it. So a teenager may feel lonely, like as a teenager may feel lonely, empty, or it may feel some kind of void inside of you, and you're looking for ways to fill up that void. Now it's very simple. Enter your secrets. Yes, good. Whatever it is you're trying or you're using to fill up that void, bro, I tell you, it ain't gonna work. It ain't gonna work. Okay, I'm gonna tell you another secret. Now, it's a secret to what you need to fill up that void. It's quite simple. You just need Christ, basically. Nothing else. You just need Christ. You need our Lord Jesus. In heaven, you need God, my Father. You need Him. Like, basically, He's the one who can help fill up that void. Once you just accept Him, you just feel that, see that void filled up. You feel like, what I've been doing so far, it's working. I'm lying. No, bro. Whatever you are doing, we only fill the void for a short period of time. And then, after some time, probably when you, maybe if it's something bad you used to fill up the void, when you realize that what I'm doing is bad, it's terrible, you feel so sad. Most of the time you feel condemned. The devil makes you feel condemned, so you feel like you've done something very terrible and there's no going back again. Now whatever you have done to God, it doesn't count so far as you give yourself to Him. Now today I'm urging you, you watching this video, I'm urging you, please give your life to Christ. It's very important, and I pray the Holy Spirit ministers unto you in order for you to give your life to Him, because God is madly in love with you and He wants you to come to His kingdom. He wants you to reign with Him as His son, as His daughter. He wants to be able to boast that, yes, this is my daughter Ebonua, she's preaching the word. This is my daughter, she's preaching the word. This is my daughter Ricky, she's preaching the word. Please, it is very important for you to give your life to Christ. Now, if you're wondering what I'm looking at, it's a prepared prayer. It's more like the Holy Spirit ministered unto me, and I did not want to forget, because it's very important. Because I was just writing it down and it just kept on coming and coming. Anyways, let's pray this prayer. Dear God, I know that you love me. Please help me to realize your love for me. Now, it's not going to be some kind of long prayer that we'll start praying, you know. But just profess this into your life. Say, today, I am ready to surrender my life to you. I want to be saved from sin by your grace. Forgive me of all my sins and help me to live a sin-free life. Just pray that if you decide to pray a short, like do a short prayer, just tell Him that you're ready to give your life to Him and you want Him to forgive you all your sins. He has forgiven you already. He just wants you to, just tell Him that you want Him to forgive you all your sins and you want to live a sin-free life. He should give you the grace to live a sin-free life. Now, after this, I'd like to say something. Probably if you're going through some kind of, like, let's say you're suffering from a kind of addiction. It could be drinking, it could be smoking, it could be watching of pornography, it could be masturbation, it could be anything. But if you are suffering from any form of addiction, after probably praying this prayer, you feel like let's take an example. After praying this prayer, now you've given your life to Christ, you decided to live for Christ, and now you go back to the scene. You feel like, don't feel condemned. God still wants you. Just go back to Him. He's going to, don't try to stop the sin. Because it's like doing your efforts. Just, it's mere man effort. You just need God. Just allow Him to come in. He's going to help you through it. Like, you won't even understand how you just stopped the sin. One day, probably when you're preaching to someone and maybe the person is going through what you've gone through before or something, you just realize that, oh my God, when did I stop this sin? Or one day, just sit down, just remember that, I've stopped this. Thank you, Father. Just don't work towards stopping the sin or the addiction. And I'm not saying you should keep on like doing it intentionally or unintentionally, but I tell you, God is going to help you out with it, and you won't even realize when you stop it. And also, most of the time, we do all these things because we're not occupied where I do. So please, let's endeavor to read our Bible every day and meditate on it. It's important to read your Bible every day so that you can get closer to Christ. My own personal conviction is, as I read my Bible daily, I know more about Christ. I know what He has done and what wonderful things He can do in my life. I know that He's a wonderful God. I know He's a beautiful God. I know He's a loving Father. I know He's madly in love with me. And no matter what I do, He still loves me. He just wants me to reign and bring more people to His kingdom. He wants me to just spread forth His love around. Because the major thing that a Christian should preach is love. Not the sin. Not you are a bad person. You are sin. You're a sinner. Yes, a sinner knows a sinner. Just preach the love of God. Let them realize that, yes, God loves you. Because He seriously loves you. So, don't worry. God has decided to, He wants to help you today. Just surrender yourself to Him. Give yourself to Him. And I tell you, your life is going to change. You're gonna be a new person. You're gonna be a beautiful person. You're going to just try it. Just try it and test a little of God. I tell you, you want more. I'm a living witness. You will want more. So, just a reminder, if you did not click on the subscribe button before, click on it now. Okay? Subscribe, like, comment, and share to your friends. Spread the word about Christ. Just spread the word and let more people come to Christ. You don't know how many people will be saved by you just sharing this. So share it. And don't worry, God's gonna help you. Everything you're going through is going to, you're going to go through it. Don't worry, everything's going to work perfectly well. God's going to guide you through the right path. Just leave everything to Him and surrender all to Him. Bye.